Governor Walker's two-year budget has less money and far-reaching consequences for the UW system. The biggest proposed change, allowing UW-Madison to spin off from the rest of the system and create its own public authority. UW-Madison Chancellor Betty Martin says the current system is cumbersome.
It's hard to be more responsible or more responsive if we spend all our time trying to comprehend and then follow 25 steps to get approval for one purchase.
Governor Walker's budget also contains money for UW-Milwaukee to consider its own spinoff. So what will become of the UW system, and what does it mean for parents and students in the state? We're joined now by Charles Pruitt, president of the UW Board of Regents. President Pruitt, thanks very much for being with us today.
Thanks, Mike. Good to be here.
Good to have you back on the program. Bottom line question in this whole discussion, and there's still a lot to be known here, but many people are asking, will this be better, this proposal, will it be better for higher education in this state?
Well, I have some real reservations about it. I mean, I'm concerned on a number of fronts. You know, UW-Madison, Mike, has grown remarkably over the last 40 years within the UW system, and that didn't happen by accident. It's an extraordinary public university, one of only four public universities in the top 20 in the country. But we need the same kinds of flexibilities that have been proposed for UW-Madison for all the campuses in the system. And by spinning Madison off, by separating it from the system, I have real concerns as to whether or not Wisconsin students will be able to get into the campus as easily as they do today, whether they'll be able to afford tuition going forward. And I'm also deeply concerned about the effect on the other campuses in the system, especially UW-Milwaukee, which will lose its research university partner within the UW system. I think tough budget times are tough budget times, but they ought not to be the time that we begin to pick winners and losers and pit campuses against one another or increase competition between campuses at exactly the moment that we all need to be working together.
Chancellor Martin in Madison has embraced this idea. She's not happy about less money, clearly, but she does like the greater flexibility. They say we can, you know, raise tuition, we can pay faculty more, we don't have to wait for approval of certain building projects. So she likes it. Mm-hmm. But your concern is that sounds great, but there are consequences beyond the advantages that she sees.
Absolutely. And I just want to make it clear, we have strongly supported Chancellor Martin's new Badger partnership. We think that, again, to preserve UW-Madison going forward, they need additional flexibilities. The business model that the state, between the state and the university, is a broken business model, and we need to find a new way forward. But we should do it building on what has made Wisconsin and the Wisconsin idea so unique, which is the boundaries of the university are the boundaries of the state, and keeping the campuses together and ensuring that we don't have, going forward, competition between campuses as they all go to the legislature to ask for additional resources or disagree within them, between themselves about that, I think is an important principle to continue going forward because it's served the state awfully well for the last 40 years.
You talked about your concerns about what this will mean for the other campuses, Whitewater, Platteville, Eau Claire, Green Bay. They talk about the fact that it could mean increased competition. Why inherently is that a bad thing?
Well, I mean, increased competition is fine if you have unlimited resources and if you don't care about duplication, if you don't care about some of the efficiencies that can come by having all the campuses under one governing system. One of the things we've worked very hard on over the last 40 years is to reduce duplication between campuses so that all campuses aren't offering the same degree programs, but there's specialization within a system. And I think going forward, that's exactly the kind of principle, as budgets are reduced, as some of the cost pressures are placed on the university, we need more of, not less of. And if you look around the country, I think there's a good deal more coordination and consolidation within university systems than there is splintering or dividing university systems. So I think competition is great, and we want to be competitive in terms of how we pay our faculty, and we want to be competitive in terms of having the best student body we have. But competition for scarce resources, I don't think, is a good way forward.
This has been an interesting situation because you and some of the other regents, I mean, you're the head of the Board of Regents, and you sort of found out about this secondhand. Has that damaged working relationships internally? You have to work with the Chancellor of Madison. She has sort of a different position on this issue than you do. What's the relationship like right now?
Oh, I think the relationship is very solid and going, and we're looking to move forward here. We, you know, obviously we might have preferred to have found out about this in a little different way. We certainly would have welcomed the opportunity to be in the conversations as the budget was being put together. But now we have a new idea on the table. We need to debate it honestly and openly and in public. We need to have that conversation across the state. We need to look at the implications of a campus like Milwaukee and Whitewater and Platteville, as well as the implications for a campus at UW-Madison. And we're moving forward. And I said at the Board of Regents meeting last week, we have great respect for Chancellor Martin. This is the Board of Regents that hired Chancellor Martin 2.5 years ago. And we're looking forward to finding a way that we can all be together, all get the kind of flexibilities that all our campuses need, including Madison, but maintain and preserve a system that we think has served the Wisconsin idea and the state of Wisconsin very well for the last 40 years.
I've got about 30 seconds left. At the end of the day, if this measure were to pass, if the University of Wisconsin-Madison spun off, do you think it would be still an affordable option for middle-class people in the state of Wisconsin?
Well, I have some real concerns about it. I don't think we know at this point. I think if you look at some of the models that are cited, like Virginia and Michigan, the case is pretty clear. Michigan, I believe, has close to 40% of the students from out of state. University of Virginia is, I think, the 8th or 9th highest tuition of any public university in the country. So those are some of the questions that I think need to be talked about and discussed in the weeks and months ahead.
Charles Pruitt is the president of the UW Board of Regents. We appreciate you being with us again today. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Mike.
Next, will lawmakers be able to set aside their hard feelings over the budget battle? We'll ask a reporter on the Capitol beat. And what a new poll says about the governor's budget plan when Upfront continues.